Good afternoon, everyone. My name is the Reverend John Hayes, and it's a pleasure to welcome you to this service of celebration and thanksgiving for the life of June Burton. I offer you a welcome, not just on behalf of Keynesham Methodist Church, but of Bob and all of the family to this service where we will be remembering, we will be celebrating, we will be praying, singing, and doing quite a number of the things that June loved to do as part of her life of faith. There will be opportunities during the service for people to offer reflections if they would like to. After the service, you'll be very welcome to join us upstairs for afternoon tea and cake. So it's an opportunity if you to have a chance to have a chat, because obviously during our service we'll be singing, listening, praying, but we won't be doing much chatting. So that will give a really good opportunity for all of you to share in your memories of June and share that together. And it'll be amazing, I am sure, as is always, of how many things come out that you hear that perhaps are new to you or you did not know. Also, at the funeral at Haycombe, there was a collection in lieu of flowers for Alzheimer's UK. So there is a bowl available if anybody didn't get an opportunity to make an offering at that time. There's a bowl available, and that will be added to the collection for the work of Alzheimer's UK. We are all part of the rhythm of life. We are born, we give birth, we live in relationships, we search for meaning, we make choices, we die, we suffer the loss of those we love. As we celebrate this day of the journey, may God's peace be upon you. Amen. So we'll be singing, and we'll be singing some of the things that June really loved to sing. So the first is All Things Bright and Beautiful. Now it's number 100 in the hymn book, if you've got a hymn book, but the words should be on the screen. So we sing All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Thank you.
We're now going to offer some prayers for this time. There is a candle alight on the communion table at the front. I'm going to invite you to adopt whatever position you find most comfortable for prayer. So maybe it's to close your eyes, maybe it's to look at the candle, maybe it's to look, and as we say these prayers, bring June to mind. So let's pray. In your image we are made, Creator God, male and female, young and old, we are your creation. You took on our life, Jesus Christ, we find you there in truth and grace within ourselves. You lead us on, Holy Spirit, in golden threads of life, in pain and joy. Thanks be to God. We had a dream about families, O God. It looked like many lights from a great stream of people, generation after generation, adding to each other's light, warming each other's life, setting each other free across the boundaries of all our differences, creating in between the brave and gracious light of human community. And we remember how far we are from that dream. Oh God, so often it's the small things that defeat us, the lid off the toothpaste, the bath mat in a heap, one more unwiped bench, the last grizzle from somebody, another gift taken for granted. These small things build upon each other, God, and when our energy is low and our hurts are high, they take from our life. It is often hard to live as family and community. Lord, have mercy on us. And we hear the word of grace in Jesus Christ. The love of God for us never fails. Nothing can separate us from that love. A new dream is always ours. So we rise up and live in freedom and in faith. Amen. I'm now going to invite Elizabeth to come and read from Ecclesiastes.
I read from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to search, and a time to give up, a time to keep, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to mend. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. Amen.
And now in our service, we're going to spend a few moments reflecting on different aspects of June's life. And first, I'm going to invite Sylvia to come and read a poem she's written. Sylvia is a good friend of June's.
Thank you. My friend June. June was kind and caring, a special friend indeed, always smiling, always there, helping those in need. June was like summer, happy and warm, bringing sunshine and joy to our days. For countless years, we laughed, had fun, and shared our lives in many ways. When June became so poorly, Jesus was there to guide. She's now in heaven and close to God with angels by her side. So June, dear friend, rest peacefully, no worries, strife or pain. I miss you so, like others, but one day we'll meet again.
Thank you very much, Sylvia. And I'm now going to invite Liz to come and read a special poem, because it's adapted from a poem that June herself wrote. So thank you, Liz.
Yeah, I was going to say that this poem was written by June to another friend of hers, and it's perfect for June herself. It was called A Tribute to June. Oh, the fun that we shared, playing Uno, Scrabble, and games unprepared. We shared laughter and fun, many a good glass of wine. June loved to be happy, she wouldn't want us to pine. So long as my friends are happy, she'd say, it's only a game we're trying to play. Yes, June was special, she was jolly and chatty, and had the gift to make others happy. When problems arose and we were in need, she was there at our sides, a true friend indeed. What memories of her we have to share, so we think of June playing up there. While her games with us have come to an end, we count it a privilege that June was our friend.
Now I'm going to invite Val to come and speak to us and share one or two reflections on her relationship with June.
It's a privilege to have been asked by Bob to say a few words about June. So thank you, Bob. Though it's very hard to keep to a few words when describing such a wonderful lady. Many words came to mind when I started to think of her. Joy, faith, song, prayer, encourager, family, friendly, kind, caring, and so on. The banners up today were put up for a wedding a couple of weeks ago, but I felt it appropriate to keep these up. Celebrate. We're here celebrating the life of a great lady who meant so much to so many people. Sing for joy and sing to the Lord a joyful song. Sums up June very adequately. June was full of joy and she loved to sing. Singing for joy. And she loved to sing hymns, singing to her Lord. And even when she became ill and her memory wasn't as it used to be, she could still sing. I remember on one occasion upstairs, I think we were celebrating the late Queen's Jubilee. Ron might change my mind and say it was a different occasion, but he was playing. And June was singing away to all the old songs, and she didn't need the words for any of them. I think she was the only person in the room who knew them all from beginning to end, and the smile on her face just said it all. June's Christian faith
was strong, and it showed not only on Sundays in church, but in her everyday living and her care for others. And she also encouraged others to grow in their faith. I discovered in due course that June had grown up and was a member of Ebenezer Church, which is where my late husband Vernon attended. He often talked about her in those early days with great fondness. Her prayer life was important to her. She belonged to a prayer group who met regularly to pray for the needs of the church and other people. She was sincere and believed that God would answer prayer in his time. Her family were everything to her. She was so proud of them and talked of them constantly. And I'm sure they all realised how much they meant to her. June was an energetic lady, always on the go, always doing something, always getting involved and helping out where and when needed. She was a talented needlewoman. She told me that she made her own wedding dress, and when she showed me the photographs, I realised just how talented she was. I also discovered this when I took on the role of designing and making costumes for the local pantomime. June became involved one year and made some of the most beautiful costumes. And the parts you couldn't see were as good as the parts you could see. As it was a pantomime, most of us didn't bother unduly about those parts that you couldn't see, but June certainly did. It was a gift from God, which she used to the full. June was friendly, kind, and caring, always there to help others in time of need. She didn't need to be asked. She just saw what needed doing and got on with doing it in her own quiet way. And I'm sure that is why so many people were kind and caring to her and Bob when she became ill. Now it's impossible to speak of June without speaking of Bob. They went together, as the song goes, like peaches and cream, like a church bell on top of a steeple. They were there for each other and had a lifetime of happiness and made many memories which Bob can hold on to. During June's illness, Bob never gave up on her. He was determined to look after her at home, and he did this until the very end. Bob, you are one in a million, and no one could have done more. I can sum June up by slightly changing the words from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. June was patient and kind. She did not envy. She did not boast. She was not proud. June did not dishonour others. She was not self-seeking. June was not easily angered. She kept no record of wrongs and did not delight in evil, but rejoiced in the truth. She protected her family and friends, trusted, always hoped and persevered. That was love. That was June. And with the letters of her name, J-U-N-E, a joyful, unassuming, never failing, exceptional lady. June, we will always remember you with love and affection.
Thank you so much for those words and reflections on June's life. A very special person. We're going to sing again. We're going to sing The Lord's My Shepherd, the shepherd who looked after June. Number 480 if you're singing from the hymn book, but the words should be on the screen.
Thank you.
And now a reading from John's first letter, chapter 4, reading from verse 16b. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, I love God, and hate a brother or sister are liars, for those who do not love a brother or sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. The commandment we have from him is this: those who love God must love their brothers and sisters also. You can see one of the other banners on the wall. Where love is, God abides. How do you know if you are loved? How can you tell? I believe that love is tested out most acutely in family and relationships. God's love that John was speaking about is unconditional. Unconditional. And I'm not sure we really approve of this. Because if we were in charge, I'm sure there would be some proper conditions. You know, if we're going to lay down our lives, we'd at least expect a little bit of appreciation. We would seek, I believe, if left to our own devices, that there was proper respect for unconditional love. But you know what? God loves unconditionally. And I believe that as love is for all, I believe June embraced a life of love. First of all, June was loved by God. She accepted God's unconditional love for her. And it is in that love that June placed her faith. I think through the love of the family, in particular through the love of Bob, who she shared so many times with, there are echoes of God's unconditional love in that, which was uniquely showed all through their life of partnership together. It is our faith, part of our faith, that we will meet June again. June abides with God. June abides in love. And June is now completely free of all pain and all suffering, in which we absolutely rejoice. So today we're going to continue to share in our stories and our memories of June, of our lives with June. So let's hold on in that sharing to that truth that God loves June unconditionally and God loves us unconditionally in the same way. We give thanks for the way June showed God's love in the way she loved Bob, Nikki and Stephen and the whole family. We pray that in that love, we too will know all that God has to offer us, all that God wants us to share in. So share your stories over tea and cake. Celebrate all that is love. That's what God wants us to do today. Amen. We're now going to have a time of an opportunity for you to remember June in just a few moments of quiet. I don't know whether it's possible to have the picture on, Clive. Is it possible to put the picture on the screen? Super, thank you. So as you may want to look at the picture. You may want to close your eyes, but we'll use this time just to remember how much our lives have connected with June and give thanks to God for all that that has meant for all of us. We're now going to share in a short time of prayer, and I'm going to invite you to join in the Lord's Prayer. So let us all pray. Gracious and loving God, we give thanks for June. We give thanks for our memories of our time with June. We thank you for the way in which you blessed and graced June's life. We recognise that many of the times and shared experiences were there because of the power of love. And we give thanks for all of that. We give thanks for June's creative spirit. We give thanks for her care and concern for other people and the way in which her smile would light up. We thank you too for the way in which June would encourage. And we pray that of all of those really important and good things that June shared with us, you will encourage us to do likewise, following and imitating the ways in which June loved us. We give thanks for this time, and we give thanks to you for all that you have shared with us. We say together the prayer that Jesus gave to us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
So our closing hymn is a hymn that speaks of God's love, and we share and celebrate in that as we stand to sing Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. Hymn. You'll be invited to go through this door and go through the hall and up the stairs to the room upstairs, the hall upstairs, where we'll be sharing in tea and cake and some words of blessing from God. May the God who binds up the brokenhearted, who proclaims freedom to the captive and promises justice to all who mourn its loss, bless you with beauty instead of ashes, the oil of gladness in place of grief, and instead of your spirit of despair, a garment of unending praise through Jesus Christ our Lord.